job as a leader is to set your people up for success. I want us to start asking the bigger, badder, better, bolder questions. I think it's our responsibility to walk into meetings with one or two bigger, badder, better, bolder questions. Not interrogation tactics, but just how might we? How do we? Get people to start thinking better. Hollywood screenwriters know that there are only two ways to define your hero on screen. The words that he or she says, the actions that he or she takes. That's all you get in the movies, the words and the actions of your hero. It's no different in real life. It's no different when it comes to leadership, sales, relationships. Your life is happening one conversation at a time. I will give you an insider tip on millennials. They're brilliant, they're go-getters, and they want to be challenged. And they want to be invested in. So here's one of the things that we're finding to be very successful in attracting and retaining top talent for those under 30. Take the corporate ladder, the one where everybody talks about the new job title, the new promotion, and just flip it on its side. Onboard your millennial by saying, I'm going to invest in you. And every rung on the ladder that's now going sideways is a project. A skill set that says we are going to consciously, tangibly, measurably invest in you and then do it. This could be 9 months, this could be 12 months, this could be 18 months, but show them that you care enough about them and their future that you're going to take the time to put them through a program that says we're going to expand your skill set. I don't think any of us would be in the room today without our incredible and amazing and committed men and women of service to our country. So thank you. The concept around team that I want to share today is taken from the United States Army, and it's called unity of command. Unity of command means that you are more loyal to the team that you play on than the team that you lead. I'll say that again. You are more loyal to the team that you play on than the team that you lead. Doesn't mean you don't fight for accounting. Doesn't mean you don't fight for marketing or ops or sales. It means that when you are promoted into a leadership position, you are loyal to management. You are loyal to your colleagues and the company for the greater good. So yes, we need healthy dialogue and debate, but then when you go back to your own department, you don't throw anybody under the bus. You don't undermine anybody. You leave a meeting with one voice and one message. How many of us have experienced the meeting where everybody nods in the management meeting and then we all go back and debate it in our own cubicle? That's not helpful. It's not helpful. We need unity of command in our businesses today. We need to go out with one voice and one message and rally behind it for the greater good of the company.